So in this video, we are going to show one of the traditional methods to make your control surface hinges for balsa-wood airplanes. So let's get started. So we have Mr. Vishal Rao from Kinetic Hobbies. You might notice him from our one of the videos, the nitro planes for beginners. So hello sir.
Hi.
He's going to show us to stitch these control surface hinges. So what are the tools required to make these hinges, sir?
Tools we require are drill with a drill bit,
okay.
1.2 mm size. Since we are using a little slightly thinner thread,
okay.
And then we need masking tape, thin CA, and medium viscosity CA, and of course the thread for the hinges. This is a polyester thread. This is a very strong, and you cannot cut it by hand. And other than that, apart from that, yeah, knife and razor plane if you have, or sanding block.
Okay.
And marker.
Ordinary blade will go.
Yeah. Ordinary blade will go.
Right.
But you need a sharp blade.
Okay. So these are the basic tools required to make such kind of hinges. So what are the effectiveness by using these thread hinges over these one of these ready-made hinges like the CA hinges or the pin hinges?
First we'll take the CA hinges. These are very stiff, so they put lot of stress on the servos.
Okay.
And apart from that, they are also prone to cracking. So if you are using it on the engine models, you have to regularly inspect your hinges, because they can they are susceptible to cracking.
Okay.
Other than that, they are difficult to install also. Then we have this pin type hinges. Even this, it is like not easy to install. The holes and all on the opposite surfaces have to match perfectly.
Mm-hmm.
Otherwise the alignment won't be proper.
Okay.
And for these hinges also you need a very thick material.
Okay.
So if you are using thinner material like say 3mm or 4mm or even 5 to 6mm,
okay.
These are difficult to install.
Okay.
These are typically used for built-in control surface.
No.
The thickness is quite large on the joints. So the advantages of thread hinges are they can be used on thin materials.
Okay.
So and they are very very flexible.
Okay.
So they don't put absolutely any stress on the servos.
All right.
And they are very long lasting.
Okay.
They don't fail easily.
All right. So guys, it's better choice to switch to threaded hinges for your balsa wood airplanes. As you mentioned, there are no friction and absolutely servos are in a little amount of stress. So it's better choice for balsa wood airplanes. So now he's gonna show how do you make these kind of threaded hinges. Yeah.
So first thing we have to make sure is that the mating surfaces, they have half round profile.
Okay.
So this is very important.
Alright.
The round surface will help you align the surface.
Okay.
Easily. So you can use a razor plane.
Okay.
So this I find it very fast as well as dust free.
Okay.
Or you can use a sanding block.
Okay. So it's gonna make a round at the edges of the control surface. Okay. So he has done a perfect round profile here, as you can see this. Make sure you make on the both sides as well.
Once you have done this, next step is aligning the two surfaces.
Okay. So once you're done rounding the surfaces, make sure you align the two surfaces exact to the other side and tape it. Use some masking tape.
Yeah.
No.
I made this simple jig. Since I use repeated hinges, this will help me make the holes for drilling faster.
Okay.
So typically, how it's like, the spacing of holes, adjacent holes are about 3mm.
Okay.
And the opposite sides, that is the spacing is around 5mm from the hinge line.
Hinge line, okay.
Each side.
Use a marker to mark.
We will make two sets of hinges.
Okay.
as you can see, there are 5 holes on one side and 4 on other side. So it has to be one more on the, always on the one side.
Okay. Make sure the holes you're making on one side should not align with the holes on the other side. It should be in between the bottom side holes. So that enables you to have cross
yeah,
threads. Okay.
Cross. Before drilling the holes, it's always better to
punch.
Exactly. So that the drill bit doesn't wander here and there.
Okay. So use some nail to punch your holes. Carefully drill the wooden pieces.
You don't actually require a automatic drill.
Okay.
Even a simple, you get something called as PCB drill.
Yeah.
You can use that also.
Leave a gap of around 1 mm between the control surface and the stabilizer or the wing.
Now we are not going to use any needle for this.
Okay.
So what we are going to use it do is just put some thin CA on the surface and then just roll the thread on it.
Okay.
No, no, just slight is enough. Don't put that.
What is the tip of the thread?
So that insertion will be easy.
Okay.
So now cut about approximately say 8 to 10 inches.
Okay.
We'll start with the first hole. And then once say about 1 centimeter length is left. Just use the medium CA. You can't use thin CA now.
Yeah.
Because if you are going to use thin CA, the thread will absorb and it will get hardened.
Okay.
So it won't work as a hinge. So this is the most important thing, that you have to use medium CA. So just on the first hole, put slight. So once when the about 1 centimeter of the thread is left, just put some medium CA on the first hole.
Okay.
Then.
So make sure you guys apply your medium CA itself, or else you're gonna have a rigid joint which can break the thread later on.
Actually, it may not work as a hinge only.
Okay.
So it's like you cannot use a thin CA for this. So once from the first hole, it comes out from the center, enters the opposite.
Okay.
Like this. And then from here, it again comes out from the center. So basically it's a 8 pattern.
Okay.
If you see from the sides, it is like
8
okay. Or infinity. So it's important to keep watching the thread alignment. Because many a times you can skip one of the holes and damage the hinge.
Okay. So it's necessary to cover all the holes.
Yeah, and in a specific pattern.
All right.
So your hinge will look like this. Even the back side,
it's the same.
It's the same.
Yeah.
Sometimes when you miss the hole, it can come from, instead of coming from the center, you directly go here.
Okay.
So that time it will bind. The hinge will not work. So very careful. So once it's entered here, make sure the thread is tight, there is not too much slop, and then you can, on the last hole, you can put the
The same medium CA.
Medium CA.
Yeah. Wait until it gets dried and then cut off the excess. Similarly, you have to do for the even the other side. We can move the parts like this, but we cannot pull it apart. Okay, so it tries to overlap now.
Yeah, so we have to make sure that these two are centered.
Okay, they are in a single plane.
Yeah, so once this is done, once you are confident of the alignment, you can put medium C on the rest of the holes. So about a small drop on each hole is enough.
So make sure you apply CA only on the holes, not on the threads. Okay. So I can literally feel any kind of friction, guys. So this is a perfect choice for your balsa wood airplanes. So make sure you switch it to these threaded hinges for your balsa wood airplanes. It takes time, but it's better than burning out your servos.
Yeah, it takes time, but the thing is you can't go wrong in this.
Yeah.
So you can take your own time, you can do it slowly, you can, otherwise in CA hinges there is a lot of hurry, anxiety.
Okay.
So you go do it wrong, you are done, you are finished. But here there is very less chances of going wrong.
Okay. It's probably one of the simplest and the best type of hinges for balsa wood airplanes. I want to thank Mr. Vishal Rao for sparing his time with us and sharing his knowledge on threaded hinges. So he's a busy man, still he took his time for us. So I want to thank him. Thank you guys. So any questions or comments, please do let us know below. And please consider subscribing to us for more content like this. Thank you guys. See you next time.